And we're back.
Exciting.
So this is more or less starting the final 2 hours of what we are surviving here. Seeing Krazy Ivanov just taking over the Jenna car.
I'm actually very surprised. I was so sure halfway through the night we'd need a splash and dash, and it's worked out brilliantly.
Pushed to the end of Virginia Racing as they attempt to get a podium in this race after all their fun and games. Oh, Krassy, that's the grass on the straight. What are you doing?
Just being grassy.
Whoa. Maybe he's having problems with arms. Abs.
Abs. Gotta change your abs.
And Schneiders won't come in for another 15 minutes.
Yeah, I think Schneiders is not going to get away with only one more pit, though. And I think that's the key thing here.
Because then you would have to do a 1 hour 45 minutes bend.
Unless, he's got a BAR fuel tank.
Or unless he just pits the hour mark and goes hours there.
Definitely a busy time for Litzinga. He's the one behind Simrace.tv. He's also the one who has to fill his database with all the screen captures.
Amazing how much space is being taken up by these stream recordings.
Well, 2 hours are about 1.5 gigabytes.
You try downloading that a 3 megabit connection. Not fun.
I think so.
Is this race almost over?
2 hours remaining. 2 hours remaining. About 53 left.
Oh, what timing?
Let's just quickly check impact on the amateur class. The green program are being caught ever so slightly every lap. It's down 8 seconds to Hellenic Racing now. That could be worth watching.
Certainly be interesting between those two, I'm sure, because isn't the stick breeding program gonna lose quite a bit of time in the pit stop alone? Quite a bit of time in 4 seconds.
Yeah.
Hmm. HRT eco bus.
The thing is, the greeting program was more recent than the deadline than Hellenic Race.
Ooh,
but, do you mean the Hellenic Racing has been out long already?
Yeah.
I think they might need to do a slash and dash then, because they've been very marginal tyres. From what I saw earlier.
Hellenic Racing is just 31 minutes out.
And stick breeding programs just pitted, basically. Well, then it's battle, yeah. There was some kind of incident at the chicane between Core Pro 2 and 05 LLM Proker. Just saw them both driving off from a standstill, both facing in not quite the right direction, or not quite the racing line, so they must have come together somehow.
Front push spun, and the building should
be heading. The deck's been down on down there now. He's going. So no harm done there.
One has to wonder what would be if this was a proper chicane.
The people wouldn't spin it.
Oh god!
That was a bit of airtime. A double airtime was on stream and he was in the air.
Try asking if he has damage.
Ronnie responds
that
not
he
really.
Has damage but not that much.
He's got damage in the same way that, I don't know. He really has got damage. Hair's width on all dampers, basically, so nothing. But like 2 years ago when a speed hump would completely destroy a damper in one go.
Yeah, true.
It was great fun, because, oh, speed hump, oh dear, I've got a bit.
Don't tell me. I had my patches with speed humps in 1GP. Totally breaking my suspension. And spinning around.
What track?
QI2.
Oh.
That's a race where Kenneth O'Keefe caused a caution. Because he wanted a caution.
Uh-huh. Sounds like Kenneth O'Keefe. Late, to be honest.
Not one has to say that series was taken over by the wrong people at the time.
Oh, so you sound like what's going on with the other series now.
Yeah. The thing was, they promised prize money.
Wasn't it like €1,000 prize
money? Yeah, but €1,000 for the winning team. I guess, I remember. I'm not clear.
Yeah, I think so too. Then it just slowly disappeared.
Yeah, there was one proper race, then the second race was, don't know, and the third race, no one turned up. So huge.
Including a guy who promised the money.
Yep, including that. And I think that were the first commentary experience for Chris Ford.
Sorry, I'm half paying attention.
Talking about the 1GP.
I don't remember. I think when I always thought my first commentary was IGTC.
I don't know what you're talking about,
God, Don does something! Oh. Ring the bells of Dominic Engel. Live for Speed Encyclopedia, walking encyclopedia. Could recite every single lineup of every single car that's ever raced in Masters of Endurance.
It's not even
Does it know something?
I can't remember most of the car numbers. About this.
What was the
good idea? Man, my hand's so
sweaty. You overdid it a bit. Didn't you, Chris?
Yeah.
Just a bit.
No, I certainly remember you doing the commentary because I had the stream running in the background. That beautifully, beautiful Frackmaster stream back then.
Oh, yeah. Oh, gosh. But, that's not too.
Frackmasters was fun, especially Kilt 500.
You're an idiot. Oh, I didn't ever notice.
Good 500 was brilliant. Capel is off in the final car again.
Oh, Oscar timing out!
Oh, so he is. Joe!
Mr. Lebrow.
Joe!
16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
He's not completely split, it seems.
Joe!
Oh,
he's back! He's back in
the
there.
Hell up in there.
He's floating.
He's floating.
He's back. No, he's not again.
Ulrich comes back in.
And ironically, the last car which did that, which is the 0-2 virus car, is right in front of him.
Initially, I also saw on the NX car floating.
That never really happened.
That only happened on my end.
Why are you waking me up from my sleep?
Because Tommy Dolman's time now. It's now floating around. Lots. But we thought I'd care, you know?
Streaming of beans, so we should let him be.
For the viewers out there, you don't really see what we are seeing.
That's because of the shift view camera, though, that TV director is using. Don't get it there. Let's get a very chittery off guard.
Don't worry, we got back up now. Thanks for your concern, Chris.
Thank you for your great chin times, Joe.
Yep.
Seems to have normalized though. Okay, it hasn't.
It's for me, better. It stopped floating.
It's still doing it a bit. But doesn't look like he's got his route is gonna catch fire in any seconds.
Meanwhile, Jan Lepovac back in the 62 green.
So if you now, go on board with Nestoras, you can clearly see the stick reading program right in front of them.
5.5
seconds distance.
Yeah.
Behind them, they've got Contour asking them to move out of the way, and they're sort of rightly saying, well, just initiate a creep pass, we cannot afford to lose time in this stage race. We're fighting for the win here.
But look at it! How much time
he's losing.
Getting close to every corner, basically.
Yeah! This gap is shrinking like the ice blocks at the North Pole.
Rogic passes Nestoras. There we go. Rogic passed and is fast ZR and is down the straight. Sometimes he hasn't fiddled with the engine. To pick their iron running again for 0-2 by race car, which is still very much in second place.
I think we should just keep an eye on this amateur class lead battle now for the rest of the race, basically, because this could go right down to the wire. 1 hour, 38 minutes to go.
There are two battles that are still yet to be decided, and that's third overall and first in amateur.
It might be interesting to see how much time the stick breeding program car loses when being lapped by the conquest car.
They're not gonna get him in a good space, that's already sure, because he's right behind them at the start of the S's.
And from Nestor's perspective, he's still losing tons of time.
No, he's very much staying with him, you know.
Yeah, he's staying with Tomek, but the gap between Tomek and...
Oh, he's very much delayed in there!
That was a late move, and now we've got the battle for first in amateurs.
Yeah, so I'll have him back off there, but... some draft. 54 as well. Nestor has certainly in the slipstream, yeah.
A lot better braking as well, probably in the FXR. He goes to the inside line, the chicane, and there's a class change lead there in the amateur class. Hellenic Racing take the lead back. That's a bit of a squeeze, though.
Oh, two bad round! But I'm not sure whether he left enough room there, but that's a disaster for Hellenic Racing team.
Got to go and do it all over again. I don't think he did leave enough room. He just seemed to want to come across a little bit too far.
Yes, he came across way too early. I mean, the stick breeding program had nowhere to go there.
Right, chase again. Come on, Osson.
They make it exciting.
You can still about see them on the straight, but I'm not sure whether that's going to be enough.
Let's wait and see.
They've both only got one stop to do, as far as I know.
Will be narrow.
Jen Arco's passed in 2/3.
The stick breeding program car can go around 20 minutes from here. I don't know how far the FXR can travel. I didn't monitor it.
Basically, I would say a lap, maybe two, between the two, how far they've gone in the stint, so, yeah.
But the FXR is going to have to match up the pit stop, though, so it's going to be very interesting to see how this pans out.
Some cars off. Medina's is off, turn 7.
Yeah, that's the Scuderia Gas.
But they're back on track again.
So he's just out of the pits.
He's just out of the pits. Cold tyres and everything. Of course, this is the driver of Joseph Ellis' favourite username. Volvo for life, if you wonder.
All for a Friskov's spinning in turn one! Friskov's in the wall in turn one! He's got huge left suspension damage! Just seen it coming at contact with the 72 FXR and just slowly ran wide and spun across the track.
Well, they're at least our lap ahead for their sakes, because that'll definitely need repairing.
That'll need repairing for sure.
Yeah, the gap in the grind is coming from behind. Just in a bit.
Oh my god, there's some of these teams are really trying to make it exciting, aren't they?
Especially in Exler. I mean, they have had so many incidents. And
I think this is probably in Exler's worst race since Simon Cattell went potty.
Probably, yes. I still remember that moment when I was on my in lap before my pit stop and I just saw him parking there. Remember that moment like no other.
It's a strange place to park as well.
It's a strange place to park, yes. Very much.
Yeah, it was on my racing light as well, so.
I was very much off the racing line, but actually on the very odd side of the track.
Yeah, but it was. I took a weird line, remember?
No, which giant you took.
You're supposed to remember these things, dog.
I don't know what you do.
Car 72 is ahead, Briscops.
That's a very interesting thing.
The interesting thing is. The interesting thing is, Car 72. Car 72 already got him into that problem. I hope there's not gonna be another one.
It's gone slow.
Chris Ford is slowly losing. The great
incidents that involves FXRs because they take such a ridiculous line with a fifth lap because they can just power up.
What is he doing?
Basically, Friskop slightly outbraked himself by trying to pass 72. What's 72 doing now?
Not really as close to the door.
And basically, so he turned tight to get to the corner while Friskop is sort of drifting along, sort of trying to stay on the.
Contact.
What's he doing?
Fighting for position, what does it look like he's doing?
Fighting for position? I think he's about a million laps down on
he's
him.
He's 22 laps down.
The last car against the first car, fighting for position.
Basically turned back in, powered it, as Friskops was sort of struggling toward trying to make the second apex. He just clipped him, kept powering on and just spun him around.
I'd be surprised if that wasn't a protest. Well, it won't, because Inex are one lap ahead of everyone else anyway, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, I've just thought there are chances I'll have a timeout soon. Because 24 hours to connect. Oh, Scuderia Gas was off in turn 9. Back corner. Having a bit of.
Ooh, for a moment. Oh. Car 07 failing to take into account the lag. Drive-through penalty, and also drive-through penalty for the leading, for car 13. For hitting the tire too often. In the movie
well, I'm sure they're gonna be not very happy with that one.
I suspect that was that alright at the time where Merlito went through the tires? and clouted. No, that was earlier.
Well,
wasn't
actually,
it?
Actually, they have doubled the number of tire contacts compared. Oh, Medina's compared to the first 12 hours.
Jesus Christ.
So their rate has significantly increased.
Still gonna be a mess-up though.
So, they are trying to make it interesting. I think we can definitely say that.
I don't think they saw that one coming down. Yeah, Prescott's very lucky in a way with that damage, because he's got on the wishbone damage lower, so he actually still has some combo on that. That's probably why he's still pounding around quite okay pace. But he probably will come in as drive-through at the earliest opportunities, I would at least expect.
Huh. Red Bull's new livery is part purple.
Of course.
And it's quite an ugly car.
Of course it is. Have you ever seen a good looking Red Bull car since 2008?
A nice comment from someone in the chat. 24 hour race, and I hear all the time from a lot of people, "Oh, I got hit. What the fuck is this? Are we racing on a public server? No way."
In what chat?
In Troy's chat, actually.
Oh.
So, some people are not really pleased with the driving standards, it seems.
A lot of the contact is just minor stuff, though.
There's two drive-throughs above out of the way for each of the teams.
Vicarant is now back on the lead lap, so any timeout or further issues for it, excellent. Virus is going to win.
I probably expect them to repair in the next stop, although maybe they're not even going to risk it, because they're not feeling too confident anymore.
Well, the lead shrinked down under the one lap mark. Dick Ryan just in the oval turn, while First Corps is now entering the oval.
Basically, it's still almost a lap.
It's still a giant lap, gap.
Giant lap? Well, it's a giant lap. The second longest lap of the season, per time and distance wise. Echo's talking about safety car, all I can say is no!
All I can say is no, because under the safety car condition, the Robin would start first, and the second guy would
better. Second
start.
Car would almost be dead last in the queue.
Yeah!
Then Ivanov would probably drive close, but he's a lap back because he's in third.
Thank you.
couple of pit stops, and I think cars like the 21 stick breeding program car, they have to pit again, because there's no way they're going to get to the 24 hour mark from here with one more stop, unless, as I said, they have a VAR fuel tank and granite tires.
So that's likely it's plenty of fuel for them.
Apparently, Nas Costigan's had a bit of a spin in turn 3. He's got a bit of damage from that.
I can't really try to remember who was it who actually made an FZR go over 1 hour, but 1 hour 10.
Nobody, because that's impossible.
I saw one guy doing it. I think it was Martin Cafal.
Where? Just, not here.
Not here, definitely not here. I don't know where exactly.
Somewhere where you need a lot less fuel.
Yeah. Was like the track with less fuel. At least it's not like Phil Diaz, who earlier was a commentator here, during one of the Kyoto 250 practice sessions. He massively miscalculated his fuel and thought he was 10 laps short.
I still remember Elvis Carr 2010 when Boofy basically used too low fuel in every single race. To speculate on it being enough.
We speculated on more cautions, it seems.
Yes. Always have way too much, I remember that.
Speaking of LFS cards, you can find the dates where the races will be held at already in the columns. What tracks
will...
You mean
in the race calendar or something?
It's not really a proper race calendar. Just the dates where the races will happen.
In some thread on the forum race event calendar thing XYZ.
It is already on the race calendar.
Oh well, yeah, that's what I meant.
And it is in the debrief 2012 thread.
So something else on the race calendar are Gen RGT1 Challenge and FBM Championship.
Yeah.
Which are still running, open for signups.
And also something which is seeking for your signup, City League returns for its 19th season. Yeah, and you can sign up by just reading the instructions in the LFS forums in the thread. There you can find the schedule and the way how to pre-qualify for the series. And more or less everything you need around this.
Somebody's turning out, is it? Ah!
Dom!
He did see his face in it, so...
I apparently have some internet... well, some router resetting going on.
Oh, so it's just 2:30 afternoon now?
No, it's because I've been online 24 hours.
Okay.
Automatically resets after 24 hours.
German routers! Mm-hmm.
No, it's with the more logic. And it's been like that forever, I think.
Maybe also something I can reveal. Just in case, if you like endurance races. There's going to be a little 5 race series in the summer month. With 4-hour races, various cars, various tracks.
All at once, obviously, not.
all at once, no. Obviously not. There's going to be an oak wheeler for our race, for example. So something very rare.
No, the Kyoto 100 from last season was a 4-hour open wheel race.
But not a double class race, yeah.
It was a disgrace.
Well, two classes in, on the May 5th, it starts with with a very interesting combo. SL5R, the GTI, so STD cars, and the UF1.
This is what you could also call the STDs if you want to pronounce an abbreviation in, or, well, spell it out.
Yeah. Then round two will be in Japan, Fox and FO8 at Kyoto 2. Round three, Alex 6 and Alex 4 at Hyundai 4. GTRs and NGTs at Kyoto 3, so here, basically. And FZ5 and Racer Belt together with the TVOs at Aston. This was the first ever presentation of this little idea, which will be run in May, June, and July.
Of early 2000?
No, not of early 2009, of 2013. Some cars was on Vortex EU. Back on track.
Oh, Jonas probably very happy at the moment. He's already had about one spin, not even a quarter of an hour ago.
He's honking.
Probably knows we're talking about him.
Where's he going?
I'm not quite sure, somewhere.
Jonas, watch out, the guy who's with the M-Class is coming behind you, pissing about, get out of the way.
Someone was asking how Team Rock Racing is doing. They are on their own lap. So no car behind them.
They
no
have their own lap?
Yeah.
Wow, that's an achievement. Even Inex has their own.
That's good though, that was well caught. Oscar, that's wide. 8-7 for the pits. And we now have a guest here in the booth. He has been here yesterday, so he knows the way
where we are. Hello to the Loris Nathomas.
Hello, everyone.
So, how has your race continued on your perspective?
Well, it seems to be that bad luck just got off our back now, and during the night the boys did a really good job. We're not last anymore, and our both cars, even our first car, is in top 5 of amateur, so that's really good. And our second car is back from dead last to, I think, 4th from the back. And yeah, though I just heard that Carl Routz have had some misfortune in one corner and now has some damage on the back, so we'll have to fix that for the last stint for me. But yeah, it turns out to be as we hoped. The night shift went well, and hopefully we'll end the race in these positions that we are now.
So, you've driven for about 3 hours. What is your impression around this race? How's the driving for you as in the race?
Yeah, I drove for 3 hours, and then I'll drive for the last stint as well. It's interesting to do driving here. I was happy, and I'm happy about the cars who were lapping us. So they were gentle, and they just waited for a good place to overtake us. And I did my best, at least, to let them pass so that they wouldn't lose time. But overall, the racing is really good, high level, and yeah, I really enjoyed every stint I did. Well, didn't really enjoy my first stint due to that gravel trap adventures, but still, yeah, really like racing here. And everyone's prepared. I just followed a few lap times, and it's really fun to see that close racing in the end of the race. Of this kind of long race of 24 hours.
Now, you had a night since our last interview. Have you somehow invented now a secret weapon for your final stint?
No. Not really.
Can you not talk about it because you want to surprise everyone?
No, basically, the thing is, at least for my car, our strategy for the last hour just to finish now, at least, since I heard about the misfortunes of Carl, since we'll need to fix that damage. I don't know. Basically, the thing is, we're just guessing who will drive the last stint for LLM 57, because they are the car we are battling with.
Yeah,
I personally was really excited.
Right behind you.
Yeah, they're really right behind us.
They're attacking you. Carl has run wide. And Last Left Motorsports is through for now, but there's still the booby chicane.
Yeah, and as we counted, they will still need to do 2 pit stops. So, they had just done a pit stop, and they will have to do a pit stop somewhere around 30-minute mark, and we should just do 1 pit stop. So I'll do my best to just keep tires going and not to damage the car. See, Carl is really battling out there.
Yeah, he's now under attack by another car, 55, and he lost the last of Motorsports car. So yeah, thanks for your time.
Man, no problem. It was enjoyable.
And I wish you much fun on your final stint. Loris Nathomas from the number 60 set of Sim Sports car.
Thank you and goodbye.
Ever closer to final hour of this race. 1 hour, 19 and a half, well, 18 and a half minutes are left. The 24 hours of Kyoto GP long. Very long, actually.
One thing I wonder, how can it be that the virus amateur car, every time I take a look at it, just looks deformed?
It's because it has always been deformed. It still looks very much like the last time I left it. The thing is, they don't even gain so much suspension now, it's just their whole body which just keeps getting smashed to pieces.
And well, as long as the bodyboard is not scratching on the ground, it doesn't harm you.
It's harder to do that in the XR, actually.
It's more a thing for the wheels.
Nah, it's more a thing for FZR.
Really?
Yeah, it's, I don't see it so often in XR. I see it very often in SLR. Well, relatively, obviously. Like when you drive, let's say, for a couple of tyre stacks, it can happen very easily in XR. That's way less likely. I'm not sure why, really, but I'm sure there's got to be a reason for it.
Oh, and the 66 had a tire blown.
Oh dear, they had a tire
when entering the pit lane.
Oh, that's okay then, in a way.
I quote Kevin, he says, a lovely timing.
I blew a tire on the pit entry, however it didn't go too well. Still haven't said what I actually did I? Well, and I think I'm not going to, because I'm going to embarrass myself.
No, you don't embarrass yourself. Don't worry.
I think I'd rather give out information on first race on demand, rather than just throwing it out into the open public.
On demand for 10 euros.
Exactly. Per word, obviously.
Per word? Oh. Then it must be a short story.
No, it's not. Actually, it is, but I can make it a very long story.
Well, if you finish the race in the order that we currently have, it will be a very black podium.
Will it? Well, in my opinion, the virus card's blue.
Well, it has large portions of black, doesn't it?
Blue.
just to count it and try.
Also got blue. It's also got Michelin's, and those logos are blue.
Okay.
Victory.
And the Jenner car would be the only difference on the podium, simply because it's not black and blue, but black and gold. Maybe.
Yeah, although gold doesn't really come out as gold on one of those, obviously, because you don't have any shiny effects or anything.
No metallic.
Shiny. So if you're using low contrast reflections and very bright reflections which make the skin look like a film with too much brightness, probably will look like black and baby diarrhea. But it's gold, or meant to be at least.
Jan Laprovok on the charge. He wants to unlap himself from a skip reading program.
Oh, they realize that and just let him go. Because frankly, there's no point in trying to hold them up.
Oh, contact!
Wait, actually, where's Hellenic Racing Team now?
They are right behind. Just behind.
Certainly closed up since that chicane incident.
So let's see what Yalan will be doing. Isaac Price is the one who is doing the final stint for NX Racing.
Very sure. That's a... They gotta do another pit stop.
It's 1 hour.
It's 1 hour 13. They'd work. Probably more like 1:10. They'd have to do. I think they could probably manage that on the tires.
Yeah, wouldn't worry it that much.
Doesn't look like Friskov's struggling for tires. Not even in the slightest.
And now there is Nesteros. No, it's not, no longer Nesteros, it's Cassandra. Cancer.
Whoa, God, Cassandra's God. Together with the Scuderia gas guard turn one, that could have ended in a hell of an accident.
Oh dear.
Why are people doing this? Like they're doing it this way.
They want to check if we awaken. And now look, from his view, they are very close to this stick breeding program.
You can see that white blue speck. Well, it's not a speck anymore, you can already distinguish it as a car. But that white and blue thing in the distance, that's the stick breeding program car.
Yeah, especially since
there's Friskov into the pits.
I could think that the 52 does not have in mind that the 62 is not on their lap.
And they're repairing damage. It's gonna be a bit of a lengthy pit stop. Would be surprised if that is actually major damage.
Hellenic Racing comes closer.
Did they do it? It's a bit of a pity that they still have to make a pit stop, I reckon, before they end this race.
But don't the stick breeding program too, though?
Yes, probably, I suppose.
I think so, because I doubt they can do distance on the fuel.
66, though. So what's going on 66?
Price in, Friskov's out. You'll finish the race, I presume.
Dakovic and Gunzelman. Dakovic is trying to pass Gunzelman to lap him, and Gunzelman seems to be saying no, and then made contact into the chicane.
Well, different people, different
joined now by the Deltones of the man from Fife, Mikhail Hoof. Hello, Mikhail. Afternoon. So, did I see you with Jeremy Kyle?
No, it might have just been Isaac. He looks like someone like Jeremy Kyle.
Oh, that was it. That's it.
He looks like the guy who goes, "You want me?"
What?
If you Google images, Google will put that in.
Jeremy Kyle is one of the worst I've seen in my life.
Jerry Springer's worse, Jerry Springer is worse.
Yes, but only because it's the American version.
I am a lesbian, but I have a penis. Jerry Springer fights them out.
Bit of trivia about Jerry Springer.
Have you been on it, Declan?
What?
you been on it?
No. Jerry Springer was, for a year or so, the mayor of the city of Cincinnati, Ohio.
But not surprising, that only lasted for a year.
Or it was a year or two, or whatever the term was at the time. He used to actually be pretty serious. He was a news anchor. He used to be a news anchor for the TV station I work at here. And he was actually pretty serious there. He had his own little political type comment thing every night on the newscast. And so, then somehow he got into that thing. He gets one paycheck a year right around December time for, I forget how many million dollars it is, but it comes in a big, a very secure envelope via FedEx. What a luxurious life. Am I right?
No. Nothing's called emails now, I prefer those.
Direct deposit.
How is the battle in amateur class going?
He's getting closer to La Pavotte, and thereby also to the state breeding program. We're currently on board with, we were on board with Hellenic Racing.
Listed Helen and Issy are leaving nothing on the table. They have been absolutely charging, trying to close down the gap. Just take breeding program for the win in amateur class. I cannot believe it's this close. They were a lap ahead, of course, Helen Racing before they had technical issues. Then Stick Breeding Program had a good lead before they had technical issues. Technical issues causing so many issues in amateur class. But here they are, 23 hours almost in, and they're separated by just over a second. Tomek Nozhek causing a yellow flag in turn number 3. He has spun. Nozhek has gone off in turn number 3 for Conquest Pro. Really just on his own, really just driving about, having a bit of fun at the moment.
These are actually the top 3 within a few meters.
Just one of those a lap down.
Yeah, that's the downside of it. I hope they don't wrench it. Oh, and La Pavotte makes room. And look, Anton's braking.
Oh, Cassandra's almost ran off track.
Look at how much space Hellenic Racing gained in the braking there.
Not too much, because they completely outbrake themselves.
That's true.
Not the seat. Let's try again. It's not the seat though. Two of the unfancy cars in this series, the FZR and the FX, are going into battle mode with each other in the final hour of this race to decide who wins the 24-hour race in the amateur class. Absolutely fantastic.
Entering the 600th lap. Didn't really forget to mention it, but it just didn't happen.
The Kyoto 600.
As Hellenic Racing get ever closer to the back of that Stick Breeding Program amateur class car. boosting stream program slightly wide in turnable one. Is this the chance for Hellenic Racing on this lap?
They are held up outside of the slipstream.
Yes, right, they're getting very close. Boosting green program go wide into the corner. They get loose on the exit as well. Hellenic Racing right up their gearbox now. Go into the sweeps. The FZR should get a car through here. Hellenic Racing will try and power their way up the hill to try and stay as close as they possibly can for the back straight. Cross 66 and again. Here the two of them come into turn number 9, sweeping right. The FZR again should be slightly quicker through here, and it is slightly behind. It raises power out, taking tighter line, shortening the course all the way, using the FXR's advantage of the four-wheel drive into the spoon curve. They need to stay as close as they can through here to get a run on the main straight. They keep a nice tight exit, tighter than the FZR. Let it run out now to try and get the toe just too far away again, it seems. Onto the oval section, down toward the Boothie chicane, and heading into the final sector of this another lap. They almost got the toe there right at the end. Have a little look down the inside, try and put Stig Breeding Program off. Inching ever closer, ever closer, and count down to just a couple of tenths of a second. 1 hour, 1 minute, 25 seconds to go. The toe this time, surely, lads. I think they're going to get it this time. They come out in the final screen. Hellenic Racing all over the back. It's about choosing your moment on this straight and not letting your opposition have enough time to come back at you in the slipstream. They go to the inside. They're going to hold as long as they can without letting Stig Breeding Program back into the toe. Stig Breeding Program back into the toe. They will surely have the advantage down into the first braking zone. Hellenic Racing come across to the right-hand side aggressively to stop the toe of Stig Breeding Program. And that looks like job done so far for Hellenic Racing. Can Stig Breeding Program
Stig Breeding Program off! Oh, God.
Right now then, game changer, Hellenic Racing back in front in amateur class after 23 hours almost exactly.
And the final
hour
has
remaining.
Begun.
1 hour remaining.
Car 66 from Hunter in turn on 2. They have to crawl the whole lap.
That's a puncture from walking up. He was just in the pits a few laps ago.
Yeah.
Oh, Helen!
Oh my God, that was very close. I hope he's gonna be very cautious because we've already seen this going very wrong. You're going far too quick, far too quick. He's straight off. Job the FZR's rear engine, so that car has some traction, even though it's on nothing that's even remotely close to tarmac. Thank you.
Oh dear God, what the hell is that all about?
What does that mean?
It's gonna be the best driver and penalty for chat I have ever seen.
Sure laser, well.
He was trying to fire his lasers.
I'm getting in touch with us, please, if you know what exclamation mark show laser means.
Probably, I think that's a... Is that Cruise behind?
Well...
Because I'm not sure which kind of instant program shows lasers.
I would quite like to go to Cruise server that has lasers.
Why, a pawn shop would already be alright, would already be great. I'm to the pawn shop!
Glen Angus lacing now in the pit entry row. In the pit lane.
I hope they get four fresh sets of tyres. Well, four fresh tyres alone would do it. I think they're four fresh sets for one car. Very interesting chat lines today.
And drive through penalty for 66.
Oh, that's speeding in pit lane.
Yeah, speeding in pit lane.
Oh dear.
Too early on the button.
Press the button, you probably learned that from Joe. Press the button, sorry, button. Well, we're probably going to see the last stops from now on till roughly 30 minutes ago, and everyone should be done. Except for, I think, Stick Breaking Program, they need another stop, the 54 AMCAR.
They are actually 22 minutes into their stint.
Yeah, so they damn need another stop. No way they can make it on fuel.
So, would it be possible to do it on tyres?
No.
Okay.
It doesn't matter anyway, but...
It wouldn't matter for a splash of fuel.
But you could probably do it if you're extremely cautious.
We've got
TRL! Oh god, I could come!
In the stand, and it's stuck!
Oscar, but that's right across where the rescue car is, so come on guys, get that out, we don't need a safety car now.
Yeah, that's turn 8.
Oscar's obviously, yeah, he knows the trick.
Oh, he's making it out.
He might
get
out.
But that's quite a way until the end of this center.
Nah, it's okay. He's miles off the racing line. I think he's gonna be fine.
Yeah, just say that the loss of time will be immense.
Well, that of course. I mean, he's already way past the split, way past the time he should have had in the second sector.
Is that car to gravel?
Yeah, but it's already getting out. You're late, yes.
Got a safety car.
A safety car, go away for your safety car.
Where's the rescue car?
I don't know.
It would
much.
Be there, but can't they,
It's on strike.
It woke up, I guess.
I think a safety car could have been called for this one, to be honest.
Not for something ridiculous like this.
There's no rescue car in the place. Oh,
who's that?
Oh,
shit, his own team! Well, brilliant, right, okay.
So oh, Robos is on the way now.
That's ironic. You are trying to get there, Tommy. It's your own teammate's fault.
It takes some minutes until he arrives there.
Not some minutes, maybe two or three. He's already at 3 minutes in the lap. Oh no, now he's timing out! Again, come on. Don't time out now. We've already got the rescue car on the way.
May I say something? That's an awkward time. An awkward moment to time out.
Eh?
Yeah, 31 seconds gone.
And Ulrich is already in. The crime and the knife.
At least we have a rescue car there again. We have a rescue car not to put again, so
desperately want the safe car there. It's Pikkarainen comes in the pits.
Pikkarainen.
Yeah, again, this was a very strange situation.
Could say that, I guess. Question will be also, looking at third place overall, how long is that pit stop for Terra Mine Factory gonna be? So that's gonna make or break it.
Terra Mine Factory into second. Now. It's going to be more interesting to see how Jenna is in comparison. I remember Crosby's stint earlier in this race, where he actually flew around the track and flew from the track.
He's doing some good lap times for a start off then. So, I hope the time loss won't be too much from pitting earlier than that. But it's gonna be very tight.
Hellenic Racing in the pit. They lost the lead for now. But the breeding program also has to go to the pit lane. I wonder if they will gamble it.
I wouldn't gamble. If you're gambling with fuel, and that's always the wrong thing to do. Oh, 71 drive-through penalty, speeding in the pit lane. You can say one thing about this race: it's definitely not had a shortage of drive-through penalties.
Yeah, that's true. We've seen 22 drive-through penalties today.
Almost one for each team on average.
Yeah, in addition to that, 3 starting goals.
Oh, fantastic! And goals count double on the point score.
So, it seems to be a very clean race, does it?
I've just been informed, or I was informed 10 minutes ago, that apparently the core powers bind of lasers is because he's a police cruiser on a cruise server, and it's from there.
Policemen have lasers.
Yeah, they use them to blind the victims.
Yeah, so there is. Nice little battle for sixth place. It's 7, 11 and 21. It's Dakovich, Noja, and
has the draft.
My goodness, Nikki didn't defend. What's going on here?
Maybe Nikki is not aware of
Norbikis.
The same map. Though, oh, he's not defending Norbikis either.
Maybe he knows they're gonna pit again. Maybe he knows they're gonna pit again, because judging from his tires, he doesn't.
Has somebody given Nikki soft pills?
He's done what Crenshaw did.
He's driving out of the
I suppose
the
that could be what Izzy thinks, so they have to pit again, so he's just letting them go.
Yeah.
Well, let's check whether they do.
Ixion doesn't have. Conquest has.
Conquest, I think, yeah. Has. Yeah, so he's just letting them go. Basically, up from the battle at all.
Stick breeding program also needs a set of tires.
Can't be very far.
Will be interesting.
Talking about set of tires, we can't be very far away from Hillen getting a set of tires in the pit stop, which he will also have to refuel in. Those tires aren't the freshest off the lot.
Though one has to say that there's still no other driver on the server.
But there's no objection, but there's no...
I could come off, back on track.
Oh dear god. Pillen's pitted 56 minutes ago, so his pit stop cannot be far away. Say 10 minutes at the absolute max. Don't think Terra should change drivers if they want to stay ahead. Well, but they're staying out for now anyways, but... Oh, it's gonna be interesting. But for me at least.
Yeah, for you in particular.
He's not having a lot of grip left in those, that's for sure.
There's a protest against Car 6.
That would be TR.
Yeah, for that. Well, I'm reading it out loud. Number 06 disconnects. However, they had to drive a joint from the pit just before losing connection. From what I can remember, he joined right after the timed out message was there.
No, I think he actually joined before.
Did he?
Pretty sure he did.
It's...
In the pits? Is... Gonna go right to the last pit store. Oh no, penultimate one. Oh, he's picky.
Right, okay, so this is gonna be interesting. Ivanov exits chicane. I think we're gonna
This
be
is not gonna
dog.
Be a very long stop. He only needs fuel for roughly 42 minutes.
Aye, they're comfortably ahead in my opinion.
Ivanov now on the starting straight.
Ahead.
Oh no, they're gonna be ahead! They're gonna be ahead!
Wow!
That's gonna be close to the last hour.
No, oh, they're gonna not be ahead! They're gonna be jumped right before turn one!
Ooh!
There we go, and that's how you decide third place in a 24-hour race!
For now?
For now, yeah, but I doubt Hillen's gonna have the... Well, Hillen's not gonna have the worn-in tyres, that's, I think, his biggest problem. That certainly didn't do the driver change as I predicted. At least Ford. They wouldn't. Wood or whatever.
One thing we also have to watch is the pit stop for stick breeding program amateurs.
Yes indeed, but I mean we saw Hillen almost jump him with Jenna with a very very slow, I mean very quick pit stop even.
And also a way shorter gap than Hellenic Racing is currently 40 seconds behind.
I don't think they're gonna get that back realistically. I really don't. I can't see how a splash and dash is gonna take 40 seconds.
Yeah.
If it would have been 2, 3, 4 laps more for Terra, they would probably be third now.
Especially the problem is the breeding program might even go for another 20 minutes. So they just need fuel for 10 minutes. Sorry, for 20 minutes. Helen doesn't let Gap to increase, it seems.
No, not seemingly, but he's gonna have to go through the heat peak. Ivanov won't, he's just coming out of his. It's gonna be very interesting. I mean, it's gonna be very nerve-wracking.
Core Racing Pro and Extension Sports Pro eventually. Maybe. They're just 8 seconds apart of each other.
Yeah, but I wonder whether they're actually close enough.
The thing is, it's half an hour to go basically. Eight seconds, that's some gap, actually. It's actually 10 from my rough check. Increased to 9.3 and the tracker.
Just between 9 and 10, when I checked how long it took for the TV cameras to switch in a certain part of the track. Is how I've been checking most gaps today.
Of course it works. I mean, timekeeping from half a century ago was not really much more precise.
I think the oldest Le Mans lap record doesn't even have seconds attached to it. I think it's just like 6 minutes or something. Well, I mean, split seconds. Oh, SPP, I'm in the pit lane.
They changed the tyres, as you said.
I think they would have just absolutely risked everything if they hadn't. And I think they're gonna easily come out ahead, though.
Next to us in the final half.
There we go.
Yeah, easy.
Somebody's timing out.
Who is that gonna be?
Oh, it's sleeping policeman Joe Littorito. No, no, no.
Nestoros now at the start finish. They actually now need a medium wonder. A miracle, probably.
Managed to get up to 30,000 ping before he disconnected.
Actually, some porn he was downloading. Here we go again. 54. Stake green program amateur on cold tires. Whereas Hanic Racing have worn down their tyres, they've got the fuel under control, they're approaching the best part of their stint for this last 30 minutes of 24 hours inside Williams Island.
They lost quite a bit there on this short stretch.
Well, I guess the set is not made for these short sprints, so...
Oh, okay. So much to our theory that on the battle for the... The GTM lead from the inside.
I think we're going to have to stay with this now. Athletic Racer again, powering on, trying to get there.
Again, they are approaching like hell.
Very hot the front tire.
But that's been happening all the way through the race so far. guess it's just something they gotta deal with on this R3, R2 set. It's very hard to deal on this X1.
So, from what we learned, 40 seconds of a gap are not enough.
Yes, certainly.
So here we go then, the fight is on!
Pizza's on. We need that music now.
Very conservative approach through the chicane from the sticks.
Since we're backing off enough to not get the drafter off the SBP car.
The important thing is to not flip it like Christoph did in the earlier stages of the race.
The Hellenic cars usually don't flip on their own. I think in round one they were flipped before they even got to start the race.
Yeah, they were.
And if I'm not wrong, Nestoros, in the final round of GT Masters last year, got flipped on a straight by another car. No, you know on AS5, that bit where you go past an old pit lane, you know, around that area where Club joins into the track? Basically got sideswiped by an Argentinian and just completely rolled into that section and ended up upside down having to spectate, and I think that was very early on in the race. Oh dear, SPP taking the Nicky line.
So we've got the Skippy line and then the Nicky line.
Yes. Two legends of LFS. Many different roads.
Both Croatian. And here we go down the main straight. They're getting a little bit closer. Not going to be able to tag here. Will they be able to stay
SPP
close enough for a shot?
Is not very fast.
Oh, he's made a mistake!
Oh my god!
Hellenic Racing, this is their chance for 26 minutes to go in this 24-hour race. Hellenic Racing right on the back for the victory in Am Class. He will go to the left-hand side, which will give him the outside line for the braking. So
he's easily going to have to track.
Easily past him. Well, SBB, oh, they're going to go down the inside. Hellenic Racing cover it off. They should get the better exit. No, they're not. The F-Star's going to get there. They're side by side into the sweeper combat. It's like, SBB. It's only an engine damage, Dom. Little bit of contact.
I wouldn't be surprised if they have, because they've not been going fast for quite a while.
By the way, Nicky is Bosnian. Not crazy. A moment of breath for the stick breeding program. We're on board with them, seeing Hellenic Racing in the bumper camera. The red, blue and white car.
Not very green colours actually.
Sion with Wyatt.
Unconventional corner there, Saras. According to the tracker, Esteras in the FXR has actually done the fastest lap in hand. No, he hasn't. No, he. But yes, he has. Okay. That's bizarre. Well, his teammate has actually done the fastest lap. I'm being corrected by Michael Booth.
So, some traffic ahead. I think that's the last Black Motorsports car. Is it?
A little Pro, yeah, that's Eichel Camp ahead. Taking a few strange lines on the oval. Oh dear, that's gonna coke and cost him.
That's the blue flag because those two are fighting, but this is definitely too late for stick breeding program.
You might see a couple more of these blue flags, because but now, so late in the race, it does count, and when you don't move over, you're not going to be praised for it, that's for sure.
Well, you never know, depending on who you're fighting with. Trying to cut the slipstream. Nestoras was slightly earlier on the break.
God, if he didn't want to use a million years of time in the draft of that car for the turn 9, turn 10 complex, or that corner. Sure.
Oh, almost rangeland through the chicane.
Like racing are right on the back of them again. They're going to try down the inside into the final corner, I think. No, they're backing off and thinking about moving on to the main straight.
I think they're trying to do a switchback and then... No, not switchback, but they're trying to set themselves up for a draft.
Yep. Very, very... Both of them actually... driving very, very cautiously at the moment. Neither wants to give the advantage that could mean the end of this great battle in the last 20 minutes of this race. Lennox Racing in the toe, waiting, going to the right. A little bit lag there.
Oh, SPP actually lifted off there.
To try and get back into the draft themselves. They will go to the right now for the breakage over turn one. side by side into the first corner, SPP back in front. Now last that motorsports, don't dare. Here come Atlantic Racing again.
But they are
to the left.
He is gonna dare. He is gonna dare.
Oh! Very, very close there. Still very, very close. SPP still have the inside line for the corner though. Can't Atlantic Racing power around the outside. No,
that
they can't.
That car's got very brakes.
Hold the inside line. Still side by side.
No, oh, and Esther has run wide.
Car 57?
The jury's been told, don't you dare.
Ah, oh, okay. Wouldn't surprise me if we have a nice and final cars in a bit.
Timing there for Atlantic Racing against Stig. Green Program are very slow off the chicane. Now then, here's a chance for Atlantic Racing. Are they going to do the same as last time and try and wait for the main straight? They are. Oh, Stig Program very defensive. They thought Atlantic Racing were going for it. They weren't. They're waiting for the straight again. Here they come on to the final chicane, through the final chicane, down toward the main straight. Stig Breeding Program, Atlantic Racing toe-to-toe in the final 15 minutes of this 24-hour race. Atlantic Racing to the inside again. They've waited a little bit longer this time to make the move. Is that going to be crucial in their attempt to stop Stig Breeding Program having the inside leverage or what I think it is? And I think they're going to make the move stick on the inside. Stig Breeding Program trying to go around the outside. That's going to be brave. Is he going to hold it for the second part of the corner? He is! Terrific driving. He's trying to move
wide.
That's
Atlantic Racing
to the inside line for three. There's a car causing yellow flag ahead. It doesn't matter though. Atlantic Racing inside for the left bit before the right-handed hairpin. But yeah, that before. He's in third position, but he's a lap down in this battle. Oh, they're making contact. They should be making contact. Stig Breeding Program, are they going to get a stop? They are just.
Oh, can they get the traction back?
No, they can't. Atlantic Racing are through, surely now. Stig Breeding Program on the outside.
He can hold the outside. How?
He's held it. Can he get the traction though? They make contact again.
Nesteros is through, but for how long? It's unbelievable.
And that's the Breeding Program who are minimizing this gap.
Good smooth corner, but Nesteros didn't get a bad one, and now it's the second. Oh, now Mayor's getting involved. No, he's not. He's still backing off, as he was told. Wow. It looks like Nesteros can give the gap now. If he doesn't make a mistake, I think this is gonna be it. Because his tires and everything, he's further into the stint, he's more in the groove than that SPP car. A hard struggle, but. Finally got there again. This time 16 hours ago, I think we were wondering how in Earth's name that car was beating by 3/4 of a lap. It's not 3/4 of a lap at the moment, but it's more than enough. this has been.
Indeed, for most of it anyway. Very, very little non-excitement, I suppose you could say. Some great battles throughout the race.
What a finish.
Finish in Abbas, weird. Sadly, despite their best attempts, I think that NX are going to win this one.
There are two cars off in the chicane.
I'm saying that surely there's going to be no way that they're going to lose the race. He starts drifting on ice cold, thin tyres.
I wonder whether he's got a pit again, you know?
Oh, he's definitely got a pit again. Sure, see those tyres we went into the sweeps there.
Certainly at the pace he was going, he's got a pit again.
13 minutes, 5 more laps. I don't think he's going to make those last 5 more laps. Just 11 minutes 50 seconds to go in this race. 11 minutes 50 seconds to go in this race, and it fears that finally both classes have been decided, unless those tyres go in the next car.
Well, even then,
is stick reading program still fairly close to Helnick?
Helnick have got away.
Have you just rejoined us from somewhere?
From base, I think.
Indeed. No, I was just away, unfortunately, and avoidable jobs.
Missed the best battle by a million miles.
I had it on in the background so I could hear what was going on. It sounded like everything got a bit hectic very, very suddenly.
Yes. It very much did. I mean, it's a 24-hour race, yeah, but we're now at the stage where no one cares anymore.
It was all under the blazes, but there was very, very little contact. It was beautiful racing. Price! Oh my, really? Lag spiking. Now then.
The virus gonna win this.
he's got lag issues.
Price would need bad luck with a timeout.
But he's got number 13 after all.
Yeah.
But it's also gotta be.
Is in.
I think they heard us.
Yeah.
I think they're worried.
To turn 90, something was spearing into the barrier and then lagged for 3 seconds. So, yes.
Lag problems? Well, we've got a lead, so let's fit in someone without lag problems.
Touch wood.
That's like a jolly good idea. Out lag and wheel problems as well.
Yes, let's not put Matthew Villiorfi back in the car.
Might lead into issues.
Just a couple.
Ooh, almost missed a pistol there.
Just quick, drive a chain and run away.
What that also means, though, is that the top three's back on the lead lap, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah. Yeah, four.
Yeah, you're right.
Hillen's on the lead lap as well.
Fresh tyres, fuel for about, I don't know, the way to the shops and back. That's it for next. 8.5 minutes remaining in this race.
All got a bit tense once again there.
But it's not been lacking tense moments this race, that's for sure.
No, it's been pretty tense. I mean, every hour's had something go on.
Yeah, and Dom had something to shout at.
Shouted at a lot of things.
Looks like the closest two on track then, for position are Ivanov and Hill, and that's for third overall.
Well, honestly, I have the feeling that Ivanov is already in cruise mode. Pretty much controlling it. Because if he loses a tenth there, he gains a tenth at the other place, and
just gained two in the next sector, for example. God.
Somebody else is lagging.
Biff, why are you no shift down?
Oh, Nicky Dakovic is having fun with the core. Well, Dakovic is also on the
Nicky. He would be on the same lap with the other core car. But that's,
miles of
already down in turn 3.
I think Nicky getting a bit pissed for this.
I think he might not be too happy. I could imagine that.
Well, thanks to this.
Three laps remaining. Three laps remaining.
Crossy lost 3/10 seconds.
He lost all of that last corner though, so like there's nothing left in that.
So maybe we can start summing the action up?
I suppose we can, yes, it's been for 20... Oh, Guns have been in Dakovic and we caught at the end. Oh, they're side by side again. Well, might be worth just wanting these two.
We just talked over there, Martin.
5 minutes remaining.
Felix Hillen's lagging.
24 hours of enormous fun in most places, I have to say. Some great racing, some strange driving.
Wheel issues.
Some laughs in the commentary box.
What's some wheel issues?
Michael Pastegum, yes, it looked like it was going to be the 24 hours race of wheel issues. Whoever got the lead seemed to have an issue.
Particularly in the first sort of like 6 to 8 hours, that was the case. If you were in the front, it went rock.
More like,
or if you were just set Hutchins and he was last. Oh, they're gonna collide! No, they're not. Right. Oh well, that ends that then.
2 laps remaining. 2 laps remaining. Leader car 13.
Yeah. So yeah, it's. I think it's been one of the more amusing 24-hour races.
Certainly not been a very boring stretch out, long one. Well, it's been a long one. I don't know. I still don't find it. I still didn't find it too exciting. because of that bit in the middle.
It looks like we're going to have Team 13 winning, despite trying their best to not win.
Yes, indeed, you could say that.
How many more ways do you try to lose a race? The only thing
The best way would be
if they beat the car on the last lap.
So yeah, that's about the only thing driving wise they've done, beat the car. Tent Robin.
And flipped over.
Yes, but flipping is just for morons.
Like Jack Sedgwick.
Jack Sedgwick, especially.
Backed up there. Wow, what a coincidence! I'm sure he feels honored now.
Probably onto our final lap this time around. Looks like anyway.
6:27 laps, there won't be time for another one after the next one. But it's 20 laps less than Decker predicted, and that's not down to safety car, which means Decker went wrong. Yay!
Matic failed. yes, I think that for a 24 hour race, Kyoto Grand Prix Long has certainly been
an interesting venue.
I think it's gone smoothly.
You can't say it was particularly dull.
Cooper fish gobs.
Oh, it's Cooper, I would just let him go, because frankly, I wouldn't want to do another lap of this if I don't have to.
He's letting go. It's been an interesting run for scops. Come on now. I wasn't being serious when I said ditch it in the gravel on the last lap.
Me neither.
Yeah, it's been entertaining. Some great battles at the start, some great battles in the middle, some great battles in the end. And normally, for the last 6 or so hours between Hellenic Racing and Stig Breeding Program Amateur, so terrific racing between the two amateur class leaders there, and that really did come down to the wire. Pity it wasn't a last lap shootout, but Hellenic Racing eventually, Lucas, though, they have got it in the bag in amateur class, but here come Robin Friskops and NX Racing. After the first hour, they were leading. And then the problems started for them. Matty Van Yarvey's wheel failing in the middle of the pit stops. Isaac Price and Nicky Dakovich having a coming together. Matty Van Yarvey's wheel failing again. Drive through penalty for Robin Friskops hitting tyres.
30.
Etc. Oh, and Mika Merlito spun a few times, I think, as well. So, yeah. It's been fun for them, I'm sure. Probably their sloppiest win in quite a while since Simon Catella had potty time in Massachusetts final round of 2011. But at the end of the day, 24 hours ago, they started on pole position. 23 hours ago, they were in 12th position, 50 seconds off the lead. But they came back, just like Blake Nozick did for Conquest Racing. But Conquest Racing had problems. NX Racing didn't have quite so severe problems. They come out the final corner, and the 24 hours of Kyoto Grand Prix Long of 2013 is won by NX Racing.
Now it is. 24 hours, 16
well, and it's,
seconds.
It's relatively tight for third place still. They're still gonna go almost a whole lap.
Less stress is coming into the chicane though.
Terramine factory now very close.
From what I know, Kraus got engine damage, so he is pushing the hell out of that car, it just won't go any faster.
Into the final come our amateur class race winners in an FXR. Of all the things to GT1 to race, appeal to win a bloody FXR, so well done to them. Hellenic Racing, they have been right up there all throughout, especially when they had the lap advantage and were thinking, I get caught here. They didn't, and then they had technical issues, and then they fought their way back. Brilliant performance from Hellenic Racing. They are the victors here in the 24-hour race at Kyoto Grand Prix Long in amateur class. Terrific drive.
So now, looking back,
the one bus war.
Ivanov, There's less than a second in it for third place in Pro at the moment.
Felix,
I wonder if Hillen will get desperate in these last few corners, or if Ivanov will make a mistake.
Oh, yeah, Ivanov does make a mistake.
So we're now going to have a battle going into the final few corners of this race, with Felix Hillen right on the back of Krasimir Ivanov of Genuine Racing. I'm nowhere near close enough to make a move here.
He's kept but close, though.
Is he going to be able to get the draft?
So now he stopped that. We think they're going to get this. We think they're going
to
get this.
Oh, no way. It's going to be a race to the line. I wonder who it's going to be. Ivanov's going to be blocking, no doubt.
He just doesn't have time to block.
He goes to the outside.
Oh, I don't believe it on the line.
He's going to get it. He's got third place on the line.
Dom, it's okay, Dom.
No way.
That's mad.
It's okay, Dom. Bob says nothing.
I don't fully understand what's just happened. After 24 hours and 2 minutes of racing, they were separated by 0.04 at the line.
Oh dear.
All cars have completed the race. Reminder, all cars return to pit lane, except the top 3 in each class. Top 3, Pro 13, 0, 2, 10. Top 3, Amateur. 6-9-5-4-6-2.
That was incredible, but I think the Genuine Racing are going to be...
has an experience.
Very annoyed.
They're going to be hacked off, aren't they?
Yeah, I mean, I think Dom was rightly pointed out. They must have had engine damage.
In
it just
racing
just couldn't get it if we were on that straight there.
Oh dear.
That is unbelievable to have that at the finish of a 24-hour race.
So, Terramind Factory is beating in a... Genuine Racing to the line.
So, as everyone now proceeds back round to the pit lane, or to the start-finish if they're in the top three, yes, it is time to roll our way through the standings. Does it look like we're going to interview the entire of the INEX Racing team first? Very possibly. So, joining us in the commentary box now are Isaac Price, Matty Venchiavi, Miku Meliota and Robin Friscops, all of the drivers of the INEX Racing car today that won by a provisional margin of 1 minute 12 seconds. So, who to start with here? Isaac, you had a few interesting moments and issues during that race as someone goes past my house. Your thoughts?
Yeah, it was quite an interesting race, to be honest. Like, it's always hard when you're like leading the race and you're always having to be on your toes because of like you can never just relax. So it was quite an exhausting race, at least.
Yeah, and like also you had a couple of drive-throughs to contend with there, which won't have been pleasant for you.
Well, the first one was just. Matty's wheel died on the entry to the pit lane, which I guess is lucky that it happened there rather than somewhere else. And then he couldn't slow down and just sped in the pits, so that was just one of those things. And obviously the tyre one, not much to say about that really, it's just our own fault, I guess.
Indeed. Matty, you were... I believe you had a couple of moments yourself in the race, a few spins here and there. How did you feel it went for you?
Yeah, I didn't think he was there.
No, Matty Venchiavi's just a bit of a mute. Is it just you here then, Isaac?
I'm here as well.
Oh, got Robin Friscops in the booth. So, Robin, you've got a nice little moment at the end there, about 5 minutes of driving. was that just to do with Isaac's sudden lag spikes?
Yeah, we just wanted to take it safe and not get a disconnect at the very end, because like right at the last lap he had a lag spike, so we just decided that it would be better that I took over the car.
Hours 12 and 20, you've racked up a number of times you hit the tires, Robin. Did you like the tires today? Was that your main goal of the day, to kill as many as you could? Chicane, I mean.
Well, problem was that when I was practicing, I was always hitting the tires, and then I just didn't really think about how much I was hitting the tires. Like, if you slightly touch the tires, that's the faster way to take the corner, where you just like flip the tire a bit to the left, but sometimes you hit it a bit more and then it gets worse. But then we got that warning, and then I started doing it less, but obviously it wasn't enough since we got a penalty for it at the end, so.
With car 72, were you a bit surprised when he attempted to cut back upon you as you were heading toward turn 2 and slammed you into a wall just at the end of your stint before Isaac got in the car before the end there?
Well, the thing that happened there was that I caught the slipstream, and then I just went on inside and outbrakes myself, and then I never checked the replay what happened, but I outbraked myself and then he hit me somehow, and then I just spun into the wall, so it was kind of my own fault for outbraking myself.
Alright, anything else about your guide's 24 hours experience that you wish to add?
Matthew needs to buy a new wheel.
Yes.
Indeed.
That much has been determined by everyone that watched the stream. But congratulations on such a dominating win and a fantastic fight back early on.
Thank you, Q.
No doubt will aid your already decent championship lead. So, looking back to the results, I'll give you a quick run through now. In the pro class, InX Racing won by quite some margin. Second position was Team Firez. Third position by only 0.04 of a second was Terra Mind Factory, as Genuine Racing gutted to have missed out on a podium in the 24-hour event by such a small margin. Fifth position were Core Racing Pro 2, with Ixie and SimSports just behind them. Stig Breeding Program Pro was 7th, with Conquest Racing Pro 8th. Vortex, with a somewhat magical comeback to be anywhere at all by the end, in 9th in the Pro class. Core Racing Pro number 1 finished 10th. Team Rock Racing were 13th in Pro. Last Lap Motorsports were behind them, with Infinity Esports Pro the only retirement in that class. Hellenic Racing Team won in the AM division, with Stig Breeding Program not far behind. Green Angus Racing got a well-deserved third after a difficult first few hours, with Infinity Esports AM getting a season best result of 4th. Savage SimSports 1 managed to get 5th, with Team Fire's AM 6th just behind them. Scuderia Gas Racing Team were 7th. Last Lap Motorsports 8th, Green Angus Racing 2 9th, and Savage SimSports 2 running at the top 10 in AM. ASX Motorsport finished 11th, with Team 6A Fondo finishing behind them, and they were the last of the finishers in the AM class today.
We are now joined by Team Virus, our representatives James Pete and Miro Rauti. Guys, congratulations on finishing second today. I don't know who wants to speak first, but how was your race? It looked fairly hectic at the start there.
How you going, James?
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah, it was pretty good. It was pretty good. Crashed a lot, got a few drive-throughs, as the usual for us. yeah, it was just the usual race for us, basically. Oh. Go, Miro.
yeah, the start was pretty good. We had a good pace. We were able to get the lead at some point, and at around 8 hour mark, everything just went downhill, and somehow we managed to climb up from the mistakes and managed to take the second position, which is pretty good.
You've done a few 24 hour races before, but not with two different classes. How different was it with just having the one class, especially in traffic today?
So much easier for a driver's perspective. We're able to do, for instance, a triple stint pretty much undisturbed, other than maybe two or three lapping cars. Whereas when you, well, I did the 24 hour a few years ago in the GT2, and it was pretty much being lapped every other lap. Could lose massive amounts of time from either getting in the way or doing some stupid to try to get out of the way of a lapping car. So I think the one class system is much better.
Yeah, I think so as well.
Well, I'm sure you'll be celebrating or going to bed just now, so we shall let you go and whoop whoop with your team or something like that.
Thank you very much.
Thank
right,
you.
Okay, congratulations again.
Bye bye.
Thanks.
I think we are attempting to get Sony from Planet News again, are we?
Indeed we do. We've got... again...
My name's Chris, sorry, I should introduce myself. My name's Chris.
Chris. And I'm gonna stick to Chris and do that.
I didn't drive one single lap of this great effort, but the guys chose me to come speak with you.
Indeed.
I'm kind of the PR guy.
So presumably you're quite happy now.
Yes, relief. Relief.
Won a 24-hour race.
Yes, we came so far, and at the end it looked like we were gonna lose it in terms of strategy. Fortunately for us, something happened with the guys and some technical problems, and that put us even on the same strategy. And if you you should give an award to the director, because he couldn't have planned it this way. If it was Hollywood, it wouldn't have been so close.
Indeed, I mean, there were great battles all the way through the final hour and right up to the start-finish line when the flag was being thrown, so... I mean, especially in the commentary box, Hellenic Racing Team today have got a lot of attention because of the FXR that you're in not being the quickest car on the circuit in terms of the car itself. But you guys seem to perform a few miracles towards the end there and really pull your way back up to the top.
Yeah, I mean, especially the two guys you mentioned before, Kazadzas and Nestras, they were really just on the edge. There was you couldn't get any more pace out of this FXR than they did. And we needed every single bit. It was so close at the end. Absolutely fantastic job, all of them. You know, they practiced so much. If you were on the servers, on the NDR servers, before the event, they were always online, running stints the whole time, and they deserve every single one of this. The lots of congratulations which we just received them, and that honors us a lot. And also, the guys from the Stig, what's the team? I forgot the name.
Stick breeding program.
Yes, really good job. It was really nice battle at the end. And the last guy, the last driver, Utotsky, was so fast. For a moment I thought, oh my god, this is not going to be enough, but it was at the end.
You guys did a good job. The AM class is obviously showing itself to be a pretty competitive one, and a very impressive show from you, and a very impressive show from Stig Breeding Program, and in fact, Green Angus Racing to get third as well, seeing as they were in the middle of nowhere fairly early on in the race.
How did you guys feel when you suddenly, at the first safety car, you suddenly had a lapse advantage? Did you think you were on easy street there before your technical issues started happening in the middle of the night?
Well, you know, Alomar is actually the strategy guy, so it's usually... If something like this happens, it's like, okay, George, what do we do now? Do we stay out? Do we come in? But he had just went to bed when the first safety car came out, because he's in Australia. So we were like, okay, what do we do now? Do we stay out? Do we come in? And then somebody said, okay, let's just go in, which was, of course, the right choice. And same thing happened a couple of hours later, almost exactly the same thing. Then we had some bad luck. Somebody was spinning right in front of T1, and there was no way for us to avoid him. But yeah, at the end, it was enough, and we're so happy. The last hour in the team speak was just dramatic. You could just feel the tension, although nobody was speaking, and everybody was just trying. It's hard, you know, if you have a bunch of Greeks in a team speak channel, it's hard to keep them silent. Like, guys, Nestoras is racing. Can you just please leave him alone? But in the last hour was just, okay, let him do this thing. There's nothing we can do about it. He's driving the car. Just let him do whatever he does best. And he did. He did. He's just such a talented driver.
Indeed he did. It was a very, very... It was the highlight of the race, the battles between you and Stigbury and Program. It was just dramatic all the way through.
I'd just like to extend the thanks from all of the teams to everybody hosting, everybody streaming, and all of the teams. Almost every one of them was very, very clean and fair. Almost everyone had somebody in the IRC, so you could chat with them and say, hey, can you please move? We're in a battle. It's very tight. And they did, which was very, very, very cool. Thank you. Thank you to everyone.
Well, congratulations again. We will see you at the next round, I'm sure.
Oh, yes. Yes, it's South City, isn't it?
I believe yeah. It is, yes.
It is. It's 6 hours of SO4.
I think Nestoras and Gazadas can do some good stuff there. It's hard to overtake, though, so we'll see.
Right, indeed it is, yes. It should be fun, though. Anyway, thank you very much for joining us and going to celebrate your successes.
Thank you for having me, and get some rest, I guess you need it. Just as much as we do.
Oh, we will try. Right, thank you very much.
Bye.
So, Oscar, you were here for most of this race, along with me, and Dilo, and Dom, who's sadly had to go and have a... I don't know
cry.
What Dom's doing. I don't think so. Come on. Anyway, but a dramatic race from start to finish there, would you believe?
You could say that, yeah. Every hour had its moments. Which, that's what you want from an endurance race of this length, is for it to remain interesting. Even after everyone spread themselves out and got into a rhythm. Because so often you'll just get a procession of people roughly 15 seconds apart for the great vast part of an endurance race. But here you just didn't. There were always, you know, one or two people that were relatively close together or, you know, accordioning back up to each other or moving away. And it meant that there was always something to talk about. And that, as a viewer, a spectator of the sport, commentator... And even probably from the teams watching in as well, that's a brilliant point for the race. It keeps people focused, it keeps us interested and the viewer interested, and all in all, I'd say that's a pretty spot-on endurance race that we've just had.
Yeah, that's actually true. What was a bit stressing for us commentators, of course, that there were large parts where everyone was so stretched out, nothing happened. Especially with one car class, it is always the problem that the lapping is not spicing the things up as it would in a two-class race. But that said, we had teams that desperately tried to ruin their races. We've had teams that did miracles and squeezed everything out of the car. So it was all in all very, very good 24-hour race. I wouldn't say it was best or something, because I still remember those MOE last lap fights. This one last lap fight was decided by a drive-through penalty. If Dom was here, he could tell where it was. Or rather when it was, because where is something.
I think we'll leave Dom well alone for a little while.
Might be a good idea.
Yeah, there's certainly very interesting racing throughout. I mean, let's not forget, I still think the move of the race was definitely Tomek Nogiek's dive bomb on was it Stig Breeny program in about hour two, hour three, when he was on his furious comeback through the field, when it was like he did a handbrake turn around the final hairpin. It was remarkable.
Yeah, the move of the race was this three-lap-long side-by-side battle. The problem is I forgot what teams it were. It was in the way before 12 UTC, I guess.
I guess really the moment with Terra Mine Factory and Genuine Racing going over the line was the moment for me. It just proper pant-wetting excitement, and in the last few dying seconds of a race, it was fantastic. I know that obviously one team's come out of that a bit worse for wear and a bit upset that they've missed out on the podium, but actually, for the spectator, for the people interested in watching this series, that is exactly what they want to be seeing, and it was a fantastic, exciting end to a brilliant race.
So, 24 hours of GT1 cars. Might be boring, some people said, in one class, but it wasn't. It was entertaining throughout. Lapping was easier. Driving standards were pretty high. There was a lot of contact throughout, but a lot of the contact was minor, minuscule, not intended. It's been entertaining throughout. Kyoto is a fantastic place. Thanks, Oscar. Kyoto is a fantastic place for a 24-hour race. I'm sure we'll be back here in the future. Oscar Hardwick, thank you for joining us today.
It's been an absolute pleasure. The racing has been great, and so has the company in the commentary box.
Theo Falkenberg, thank you for sticking around for 24 hours unabated, basically.
Well, I had my 8 hours of sleep, so...
Oh, well then. Soft as I am. Stephen Martin, with broken wrist. Thank you for assisting us if you were there.
You're welcome. Been a pleasure.
Michael Booth, thank you for doing administration and then saying some things in the stream just now.
Thanks you too for commentating for so long, and also
thank you of course to Dominic Cole, who has left us. Thank you to all interviewees throughout the race. Thank you to all the race administration, especially Jonathan Palmer, who's been up 24 hours. I don't even think he's had a sandwich. We will be back for the next round of the series, which is when? I think you know more than I do, Oscar.
Someone's probably going to beat me to it here. But I know it's the 6 hours of SO4.
Uh-huh. The 9th of March.
9th of March, 2013. That's going to be very, very interesting. I think we've got an FXR car in the amateur class that's ready to win again.
Possibly.
Remember that phrase?
Yeah. Ready to win.
That was a team that finished second that coined that phrase, I do believe. Anyway, right. Thank you for joining us. It's been a pleasure. Till next time, goodbye.